one of the reasons why I want to make sure we all had the same understanding is because a couple of years ago, people were using the term rubric over and over again. And every meeting I went to, they were like, did you write a rubric? Did you write a rubric? Well, the problem was, is I had no idea what a rubric was. And everybody made me feel like I should know what one was. And so I spent several years going, and never really knowing what in the world a rubric was. And everybody was using the term, like I felt stupid. If I asked somebody, can somebody tell me what a rubric was? Eventually I did figure it out. But I think there are terms that we use, and there might be people that actually have no idea what it means. They just use it, or they hear it used, and don't even know. But they don't want to ask somebody what it means, because everybody uses the term. So, when the music starts, what might somebody, a teacher at Reese Puffer, say an effective question is? How would they define it? So I talk to your neighbors, go.
I would say one of the things that students actually think in classes, maybe not necessarily a yes or a no, but someone really wants to actually think or process.
I would concur. And I think that there are different questions that get to filter and get to different levels of
yeah. There's definitely a time or place for yes or no.
Shot three or four times this summer for the last 12 years. And it's amazing how I still, every time I hear it, I get something different or I get something that I'm like, oh yeah, I need to do more with that. So hopefully, if you've heard stuff on effective questioning before and you've been dabbling with it in your classroom, that you'll hear something that you had forgotten or something that is an aha for you. You were just talking about what an effective question is. And you probably came up with things like an effective question promotes learning. Engages all students, not just one or two students. Exposes the student knowledge, what they know and what they don't know yet, so it drives our instruction. It occurs with every major point. Provides teacher with possible next steps, and we'll talk about more specifically what those are. Go ahead, we're family.
Are you gonna share this so I don't have to type all this?
I can.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So you can take a photo of it, and I'll photobomb it. Yeah, I had, this is all digital.
Okay,
all
right.
Thank you.
Yeah, so that's what an effective question is, in essence. It's getting everybody involved. It's where learning is occurring, and we're going to talk about what it looks like at, when they say after every major point, and then it gives you possible next steps. So it drives your instruction. Also, we have accountable questioning, and it says accountable questioning is any form of questioning in which all students interact with and learn good answers. So everybody is involved. Every student participates in some form of interaction, processing a good response. So sometimes it's questioning, sometimes it might be writing and things like that, but everybody is involved in the learning, everybody's involved in the questioning, everybody's participating. Whether they're the listener, whether they're the talker, everybody's participating. So that's the kind of questions we're going for, is these questions that get everybody involved, learning's involved. But think back to what was questioning like when you were in school. Just think for a minute, or when we all learned to teach. What did questioning look like then? When the music starts, talk to the people around you. What did questioning look like in school or when you learned to teach?